Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. I am your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we'll discuss 5 more questions from the PIB news. This series is beneficial for various government exams like UPSC, State PSC, RBI and etc. So let's begin with the first question guys. As per the latest key world energy statistics published by the International Energy Agency in 2019, what is true in respect of India? Option number 1 is India is the 4th largest producer of electricity in the world. It ranks 106th in terms of per capita consumption in 2017. And option number 3 is India has become power surplus from power deficit situation. Now this International Energy Agency is headquartered in Paris and it is headed by Dr. Fatih Birol. It is headed by Dr. Fatih Birol and this agency currently has 30 members and it was established in 1974. So it was established in 1974 and it works basically as a policy advisor in the field of energy to all the member nations and also to all the non-member nations like India, China and Russia. Okay, so it works as a policy advisor in the field of energy. And it was established in 1974, headquartered in Paris and headed by Dr. Fatih Birol. So this International Energy Agency has released key world energy statistics, which provides overview of the world electricity developments like world electricity and heat production, supply and consumption, electricity import and export. And according to this report, India is the 3rd largest producer of the electricity in the world and India is ranked 106th. In terms of per capita consumption in 2017 and now India has become power surplus. Okay, so according to the report published by International Energy Agency, India is now the 3rd largest producer of electricity in the world and India ranks 106th in terms of per capita income per capita consumption of electricity in 2017 and India has become power surplus from power deficit situation. एंड अभी रिसेंटली आप लोगों को पता होगा इंडिया में इलेक्ट्रिसिटी को 100% बनाने के लिए गवर्नमेंट ने लॉन्च किया था सौभाग्य योजना, जिसके बाद इंडिया का जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कंजम्पशन है वो भी काफी बढ़ा है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोडक्शन में भी काफी इंक्रीज आया है. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन. वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ इंडिया. सो इंडिया इज द 4th लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. नो, इंडिया इज द 3rd लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन द वर्ल्ड and it ranks 106th in terms of per capita consumption in 2017. Yes, this option is correct. And India has become power surplus from power deficit situation. Yes, this is also correct. So therefore, option number E must be the right answer, which says only 2 and 3. And Minister of Power is Mr. R.K. Singh. Okay, Minister of Power in India is R.K. Singh. And this International Energy Agency is headquartered in Paris, headed by Dr. Fatih Birol. Next question is, as per the Desertification and Land Degradation Atlas of India, prepared by the Space Application Center for the period 2011-2013, approximately how much percent of the total geographical area of the country is undergoing the process of desertification or land degradation? So guys, this Desertification and Land Degradation Atlas was launched in 2016 and it has been prepared by Space Application Center of ISRO. This is a branch of ISRO, Space Application Center. It is located in Ahmedabad. Alright, so Space Application Center is located in Ahmedabad and it is an arm of ISRO. So, ye jo Space Application Center hai, ye karta kya hai? Ye स्पेस इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स को डिजाइन करता है फॉर वेरियस मिशंस ऑफ इसरो. ठीक है, इसका काम क्या है? फॉर डिजाइनिंग, टू डिजाइन स्पेस इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स फॉर वेरियस मिशंस ऑफ इसरो एंड इट इज लोकेटेड इन अहमदाबाद. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस एटलस, टोटल 29.32% ऑफ द टोटल ज्योग्राफिकल एरिया इज अंडरगोइंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिजर्टिफिकेशन और लैंड डिग्रेडेशन. And in Uttar Pradesh, 6.35% of land is undergoing desertification. This atlas presents state-wise desertification and land degradation status. आप लोगों को सबको पता होगा कि last year 2019 में इंडिया में COP14 हुआ था, Conference of Party 14 हुआ था of UNCCD, जिसमें इंडिया ने एक टारगेट सेट किया था that India will restore 26 million hectare 26 million hectare of degraded land by 2030 तक इंडिया 26 मिलियन हेक्टेयर डिग्रेडेड लैंड को रिस्टोर करने का काम करेगा, ऐसा टारगेट इंडिया ने सेट किया था इन COP 14 ऑफ UNCCT जो लास्ट ईयर इंडिया के ग्रेटर नोएडा में हुआ था। ऑलराइट, नाउ अभी ये चीज न्यूज में इसलिए है बिकॉज देर आर वेरियस स्टेप्स दैट आर बीइंग टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया टू कॉम्बैट द डिजर्टिफिकेशन एंड द लैंड डिग्रेडेशन इन इंडिया। लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल ICAR इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल रिसर्च विद द हेल्प ऑफ इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ सॉइल एंड वाटर कंजर्वेशन has developed bio engineering measures to check soil erosion. Soil erosion को check करने के लिए कुछ bio engineering measures adopt किए हैं ICAR ने through Indian Institute of Soil and Water Conservation. That's why ये जो atlas था ये news में था। अब बहुत सारे ऐसे steps जो है वो government of India ले रही है, but आपको सारे steps याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, since ये news में था तो इसके बारे में हमें पता होना चाहिए। Now the question is how much percent of the total geographical area of the country is undergoing the process of desertification of or land degradation? So the answer is 29.32%. So approximately it is 29%. Therefore, A 29% is the right answer. Next question is regarding the global ranking of higher institutions of India, which among the following statements are correct? Statement 1 is in 2020, QS list of 1000 global institutes, 24 Indian higher education institutes are listed. And statement 2 is there are 36 Indian higher education institutes in Times Higher Education Global 1000 Institute. So guys, in 2020 QS list of 1000 global institutes, MIT was ranked at number 1, and among Indian universities it is IIT Bangalore jisko rank 1 mila tha. Okay, and overall ranking jo thi IIT Bombay की जो ओवरऑल रैंकिंग थी वो थी 152 एंड इंडियन यूनिवर्सिटीज में ये नंबर 1 पे था। ओके, और ओवरऑल नंबर 1 पे कौन था? MIT एंड देयर वर 24 इंडियन हायर एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूट्स इन 1000 ग्लोबल इंस्टीट्यूट्स रैंकिंग ऑफ QS। ओके, एंड इन टाइम्स हायर एजुकेशन ग्लोबल 1000 इंस्टीट्यूट इट इज द ऑक्सफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी which secured rank 1, and among Indian institutes the rank 1 is of IISc which is in Bangalore, Indian Institute of Science which is in Bangalore. Okay, so Times Higher Education ki ranking mein Oxford University was number 1 and among Indian universities it is IISc Bangalore, and QS list mein it is MIT jo ki number 1 pe tha, and among Indian institutes it is IIT Bombay. Times Higher Education एक वीकली मैगजीन है, हेडक्वार्टर इन लंडन, एंड ऑल्सो QS इज अ ग्लोबल एजुकेशन कंपनी, इट इज ऑल्सो हेडक्वार्टर इन लंडन। एंड टाइम्स हायर एजुकेशन के जो ग्लोबल 1000 इंस्टीट्यूट थे उसके अंदर इंडिया की जो यूनिवर्सिटी थी वो थी टोटल 36। ऑलराइट, एंड इन QS लिस्ट ऑफ 1000 ग्लोबल इंस्टीट्यूट 24 इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट वर देयर। सो देयरफॉर बोथ द स्टेटमेंट आर एब्सोल्यूटली करेक्ट एंड वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, hence C both are correct must be the right answer. Next question is implementation of the national policy and action plan 2015 has resulted in consistent decline in left wing extremism related violence in the country during last 5 years. In 2019 the number of LWE related incidents have reduced by over dash in comparison to 2014. Now this national policy and action plan was launched in 2015 by NDA government, National Democratic Alliance government, and it aims to address the LWE issue in the country. जो left wing extremism का जो issue है, नक्सलाइट का जो issue है, Maoist का जो issue है, उसको address करने के लिए, उसको कम करने के लिए NDA government has launched this national policy and action plan in 2014. Now why this action plan is in news? Because government has recently said that there is a reduction in the number of LWE related incidents in 2019 as compared to 2014. And how much percent it has been decreased? It has been decreased by approximately 38% as compared to 2014. Now in 2015 the number of LWE related incidents were 1089, while in 2019 it was reduced to 70. Okay, and this also according to the government, in 2009 the number of security personnel killed in LWE extremism were 317, while in 2019 it has been reduced to just 52. 2009 में security personnel के मारे जाने की जो numbers थे वो थे 317 और 2019 में ये कम होके कितने हो गए 52. So this national policy and action plan ने काफी impact जो है वो create किया है in the field of left wing extremism in the country. And there is one term which is associated with the LWE, which is red corridor. अब ये red corridor क्या है? Red corridor is a region in the eastern, central and southern parts of India जहां पे नक्सलाइट और माओइस्ट की जो इंसर्जेंसी है वो बहुत ज्यादा है. ओके, रेड कॉरिडोर इज अ रीजन इन द ईस्टर्न सेंट्रल एंड सदर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया जहां पे नक्सलाइट एंड माओइस्ट इंसर्जेंसी बहुत ज्यादा है. सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन. इन 2019 द नंबर ऑफ LWE रिलेटेड इंसिडेंट्स हैव रिड्यूस्ड बाय ओवर डैश इन कंपैरिजन टू 2014. सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज A, 38%. ओके, एंड लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे इज, एज पर स्टडी ऑफ द वाडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हिमालयन जियोलॉजी देहरादून, ग्लेशियर्स ऑफ विच स्टेट आर मेल्टिंग एट अ हायर मैग्नीट्यूड एज कंपेयर टू अदर हिमालयन रीजन्स. सो दिस वाडिया इंस्टीट्यूट is a research institute for the study of geology, which it works in the Department of Science and Technology. And as per the study of the Wadia Institute of Himalayan Geology, glaciers in Sikkim are melting at a higher magnitude. And the reason to this is the higher magnitude of dimensional changes and debris growth. Debris growth ke badhne se aur dimensional changes aane ki wajah se, jo Sikkim ke glaciers hain, wo bahut jaldi melt ho rahe hain as compared to the other Himalayan regions. And this is a study of Wadia Institute of Himalayan Geology, which works under the Department of Science and Technology. This Wadia Institute of Himalayan Geology is located in Dehradun. Okay, Dehradun, which is in Uttarakhand. Alright, so now come to the question. Question is, glaciers of which state are melting at a higher magnitude as compared to other Himalayan regions? So the answer is C, Sikkim glaciers. Okay, alright, so that was the session, guys. I hope you like the session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Goodbye, take care, God bless, and keep watching PIB 24/7.